Hi students, here we discuss the monostable multivibrator using IC555. As you know, the monostable means one stable state, that is output either remain in the high state or low state. So as you know, in the internal block diagram of the multivibrator, there are two comparators, one SR flip-flop, one transistor and voltage divided network is there. So for this circuit monostable, external components required, resistor and capacitor. Okay, and we change this state by giving the trigger input at the pin number 2. So here we give the negative going pulse to the pin number 2. So now we discuss the working of the monostable multivibrator. So at time t is equal to 0, we assume that our timer output, that is Q bar, is equal to 0. As Q bar is 0, Q is equal to 1, that is the transistor is on, that it is acts as a short circuit. Then capacitor, initially there no charge on the capacitor, so capacitor start discharging through transistor. So voltage on the capacitor is 0 initially, and output we already assume it is 0. Okay. Now when at time t is equal to t1, so negative going pulse crosses the 1/3 VCC, that is the voltage at the pin number 2 goes below 1/3 VCC, the output of the A2 comparator goes high. That is the voltage at the non-inverting, that is 1/3 VCC, and inverting it is less than 1/3 VCC. So non-inverting is greater than inverting, so output of the A2 is high. That is S is equal to 1, and R is equal to 1. Similarly, the voltage on the capacitor is 0, so this is present at the non-inverting terminal of the A1, and inverting is connected to the 2/3 VCC, so A1 goes low. That is S is equal to 0. That means the flip-flop is reset. Flip-flop reset, that is the Q is equal to 1 and Q is equal to 0s, and Q bar is equal to 1. That is the timer at time t is equal to t1, output voltage goes high. As the output voltage goes high, and similarly at that time the transistor t is equal to, the transistor is in the off state because Q is equal to 0. So transistor is in the off state, so it acts as an open circuit. Now capacitor starts charging through the RA. So in this way, now capacitor start charging through R like this, with the well polarity positive negative like this. So at time t1, the output goes high and capacitor starts from 0 towards the VCC. When the voltage across the capacitor cross the 2/3 VCC, at that time we call this as the time T2. So at time T is equal to T2, so VC is greater than 2/3 VCC. That is, this voltage is present at the non-inverting terminal of the A1. So that is the non-inverting is greater than the inverting, so A1 output goes high. Similarly, at that time the trigger input goes high, VCC, trigger input is at the VCC, so A2 goes low. So A1 high, that means S is equal to 1, and A2 is low, that is R is equal to 0, that means the flip-flop is set. So flip-flop set, that is Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 0. That is the transistor T is in the on state and that acts as a short circuit. Transistor T on, that acts as a short circuit. That means the now capacitor start discharging through the transistor. So capacitor discharges through transistor in this direction. So as and now Q bar is zero, that is the output is zero, output is low. So at time t is equal to t2, output goes low. So output goes low. Now output goes low. So this is continuous and capacitor discharges like this, exponentially like this. Okay, so like this. So capacitor discharges like this, and when next pulse comes, at that time again the output goes high and capacitor start charging. This is the working of the monostable multi vibrator. Now to calculate the pulse width of the monostable multi vibrator, so we require the one equation, that is the charging voltage of the capacitor. So that equation is given by charging voltage of capacitor is given by Vc is equal to Vcc into bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t upon r into c. Here Vc is equal to, as you know, the capacitor charging from 0 to 2/3 Vcc. So we write here Vc is equal to 2/3 Vcc minus equal to Vcc into 1 minus, now t is equal to t on, minus t on upon r is here, capacitor charges through Ra. So we write here Ra into c and bracket complete. When we simplify this, so we get t on is equal to 1.1 into Ra into c. So this indicate the pulse width of the monostable multivibrator depends on the resistance and capacitor only, not on the power supply. So this is about the monostable multivibrator.